I have sworn by my blood, as your man, my love, that one day, I promise one day your heart it will stop. But I've never changed.
Hey, folks, the late, the great David Ruffin. Common Man, what a fantastic song. And for you Jay-Z lovers out there, did you know he sampled that? I'll give you just a little more taste of David Ruffin. God rest his soul, Common Man. What a voice, forget about it. Hey folks, this is Bad Brad Berkowitz, the host of the Bad Brad Berkowitz Show, and this is another RSR video email bag. Forget about it. Now, before we start, as we always do, make sure you sign up for the RSR YouTube channel. And you guys are signing up because our numbers are going up. So I'm going to say it's because of two things. You love the videos. You're enjoying my show. And not just my show. Forget about it. You're enjoying the Fighting Cowboy, James Quartillis' Quicks RSR video email bag. We're bringing them to you. We're bringing them to you left, right, and center. We're getting so many questions, we got to do several bags a week. But we told you we would do it. You asked us to take it to another level. And we did. Forget about it. So without further ado, while you're going to sign up for the channel, what are you looking at me for? I know you like the fedora. Forget about it. Let's get into your questions. And the first question is, Bad Brad, I'm calling WTF on fighters these days. You have Oscar De La Hoya in stilettos with fishnets and a $1.98 wig on. Okay. You have Roy Jones showing his prickin' selfies and sending it to whores. Oh, boy. Okay. Well, I said we read them as is for the most part. And you have Adrian Broner bragging about himself having crabs on a video. Do you think these dumb moves by each fighter affects their boxing legacies? I personally do. And though I am not stupid to realize fighters of the old days didn't have the net up their asses or TMZ, I really do think they conducted themselves in a different way. What are your thoughts on this cool cat? Signed, Edwin T. all the way from Denmark. Whoa, Edwin T. Forgot about it. You're not pulling no punches, pal. Okay, well, first of all, let me say this. You made a valid point, and I always use this in politics. I don't really talk politics, but I always use this as far as what President Kennedy was able to get away compared to what a president today could get away. You're absolutely right. You got the internet. You got TMZ. You got paparazzi up there quackamazoos. So you can't fart without it being recorded on a cell phone or whatever. So I agree with you there. Now, in answer to your question, does their personal behavior affect their boxing legacies? Well, I'm probably going to shock you here. Look, they made dumb moves. They got caught. There's other people that made dumb moves, and they haven't got caught. But honestly, what they do in their personal life, whether they embarrass themselves or they embarrass their families and they have to live with that, I feel they don't affect their boxing legacies. So Roy Jones, for example, sending pictures of his Rajul to somebody over text or however he did it, doesn't affect what he did in the ring. What affects him what he did in the ring is fighting on too long. Now, I think that's affecting his legacy. That I will concur if you did say that or you thought it. But sending pictures? No. Oscar De La Hoya in drag? No. How does it affect his legacy? He still fought everybody out there. Now, what's funny about Oscar, he's been pissed off lately, so I don't know, Oscar, do you need a hug? What's going on with you, buddy? Call me. We'll do lunch. Forget about it. But that's the answer to your question. No, I don't think it affects their legacies, what they do outside the ring. Okay? There you go. Next question. Bad Brad, longtime reader, Ringside Report, and you guys are the cream of the cream, let me tell you that. I wanted to know, who are your three favorite trainers of all time in boxing? Thanks, Marty D. from Miami Beach, Florida. Well, Marty D. from Miami Beach, Florida, my old stomping grounds, forget about it. That's a great question. And I'm going to give you my personal three off the top of my head. Okay, now people say, oh, well, they're my personal three. That's what you asked for, did you not? So, number one, Angelo Dundee, God rest his soul. Sugar Ray Leonard, Muhammad Ali, George Foreman, James Quartillis, Carmen Basilio, And the list goes on and on and on and on and on. Plus, I knew him personally. And he was a beautiful man. He was wonderful. He was kind to my dad. He was nice to me. I interviewed him. I stayed in touch with him over the years. Lost touch the last couple of years that he was alive. But whenever I did reach out to him, used to call his office in North Miami Beach, and his secretary, I wanted to say her name was Dorothy, used to answer the phone, and he'd get on there, and he'd have a one-liner, and he'd break me up every time. So my number one, Angelo Dundee. My number two, God rest his soul, Emmanuel Stewart. I don't even need to say anymore. Kronk Jim, it goes without saying. And my number three was one of my favorite boxing analysts. Not my number one, because that's Al Bernstein, as everybody knows. But he's in my top five, was a boxing analyst and a trainer. Another one, God rest his soul, Gil Clancy. Loved Gil Clancy. He loved his fighters. I got a chance to talk to him in 2001 at the International Boxing Hall of Fame. And I asked him a question about Jerry Quarry, and he lit up. He said, people don't ask him about, or at that time, they didn't ask him that much about Jerry Quarry. It was all but forgotten. And he really appreciated that. He answered the question, and he went into great detail. He was very fond of Jerry Quarry. Okay, so those are my three. Dundee, Stewart, and Clancy. All right, forget about it. Last question. Bad Brad, your fedora's cool, your lips make me want to go to shul, and your video e-bags rule. Email bags rule. I don't even know, need to go. I can't even talk. Look, I'm tongue-tied. Imagine that. I don't even need to go any further. I know who this is. I know who this is. Janice, this is you. Forget about it. I'm going to read the rest of your question. There you go. What's a Jewish girl from the Bronx supposed to do knowing you are taken, but I'm not faking? I love your forget about it swag. I know I made you laugh on my rhyme, but let me tell you, I do think of you all the time. Oh, you're a regular poet, a Jewish Bundini Brown. Forget about it. And she goes on to say, just saying, hey, if I can't have you, then at least I can get you to answer my questions. So here goes my question. What was the story on Tony Ayala as a fighter, and it seems he never stayed out of trouble? Hugs and kisses, Janice F., Bronx, New York. Janice F., my Meshuggahna, my Blue Jew from the Bronx, New York. Forget about it. Well, you cracked me up. You cracked Debbie and I up, because every time you send an email and I answer it, I get a text from Debbie, or I get a yell from the other room if she's home saying, ah, Janice is back. So, in answer to your question, Tony Ayala. Well, let's talk two sides of Tony Ayala. Let's talk the good side first. I always like the good before the bad, unless it's news. Give me the bad news first, because the good news is always going to be there. But let's address the good first. He was a bad man in the ring. Knocked out everybody, but he was an animal. In a good way and a bad way. I seen him knock out Robbie Epps one time and spit on him. It's disgusting. It's classless. Could have been a great, great fighter. Never got tested because now the bad. He was a piece of garbage outside the ring. I said it. I know he's dead. You don't get a pass. You don't get a pass from me. If you're a piece of shit in life, you're a piece of shit in death. I don't care who it is. He was. And I'm not. He was bad. He raped a woman. He got out and pulled that bullshit again. Okay? So he wasn't no friggin' good. Okay? And I'm not going to absolve him of his sins. I don't buy that. Okay? And I believe in the man upstairs. I'm not going to go into a religious sermon here. But I'm not forgiving him for what he did. Because he did some heinous crimes. So he's a piece of shit outside the ring. Inside the ring. But hey, that was his fault. He came back out when he got out of prison. He finally got beat. He's the only fighter I've ever seen. There may be another one, but the only one I've ever seen, Jess, that actually fought with an ankle bracelet on his ankle in the ring. I think it was on ESPN. It might have been against Tony Menefee or something like that. Look it up. I'm going to look it up because I think that's who it was, but I'm going to have to double check. So there you have it. Could have been something special. Screwed up his life. Now he's passed away. Good riddance. I know that's might be cold. I'll probably take some heat on it. But you know what? I am who I am, and I'm always honest. I don't pull no punches for anybody. All right? Forget about it. So, folks, that's another RSR video email bag. Make sure if you want to be on the show, send your questions in too. ringsidereport2014@gmail.com. That's ringsidereport2014@gmail.com. And as we always do, forget about it. It's another show in the can. And as Frank Sinatra sang, so eloquently so long ago, the best is yet to come. Bad Brad out.